शुक्लं ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमाम् आद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीं अभयतां जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्देतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदाम्।
षष्ठी स्थाने योगा, इट इज अ परिभाषा सूत्र। परिभाषा सूत्र इज यूजफुल इन इंटरप्रेटिंग अदर सूत्रास। सो ए परिभाषा सूत्र इज यूजफुल टू इंटरप्रेट अदर सूत्रास। नाउ इन ए पर्टिकुलर सूत्र सपोज देयर इज अ षष्ठी विभक्ति, a word in Shashti Vibhakti. What does the Shashti Vibhakti signify? It is given by the Sutra Shashti Sthane Yoga. For example, let us take the Sutra Eco Energy. Ikaha is Shashti Vibhakti. Yan is Prathama Vibhakti, Achi is Saptami Vibhakti. Number 6177 is the number of this sutra. Now, Ikaha is a Shashtyanta, right? It is Shashti. What does this Shashti Vibhakti signify? We have to understand. So Shashti can have any meaning. So it can be Avayava Shashti also, Ikaha Avayavaha, or anything, Ikaha Sambandhi, anything related to Ik. So many meanings are possible for Shashti. Then, when we are not clear what is the meaning of Shashti Vibhakti, Panini has given the paribhasha, Shashti Sthane Yoga. Shashti Sthane Yoga. This is a paribhasha sutta. This helps us in interpreting this Shashtyanta Shabda. And this sutra, this Paribhasha sutra, what is the number? 1 1 1. This Paribhasha sutra says
1149.
According to this Paribhasha sutra, if there is a Shashtyanta Shabda, word in a sutra, it should be associated with the Sthane. Sthane. In the place of, See here, ikaha is a shashtyanta shabda. So, shashti sthani yoga, sthani ityanena, yoga association, yasyahasa sthani yoga. So, if there is a shashtyanta, then it should be understood as having connection with the word sthani. So, based on this, we can understand ikaha. Ikaha means ikaha sthani. How do we get sthani? Because of shashti sthani. In the place of ik. This is the purpose of the Paribhasha Sutra. Shashti sthani yoga. That is shashti sthani yoga. Then sati saptami or bhava saptami. Sati saptami or it is also known as bhava saptami. This is another usage of saptami. We have seen one usage of saptami. What is that? What is that? Saptami adhikarane cha. Adhikarana saptami. Saptami has the meaning of adhikarana. It is one meaning. Like Ramaha. Ramaha ayodhyayam vasati. Ramaha grihe vasati. Grihe is saptami. It is adhikarana saptami. Now, we are looking into another usage of saptami called sati saptami. See, it is a little complex. Sati Saptami is generally used with Ekradanta. Generally, it is used with certain Kradantas like a Shatru Shanakya. Varpta Tanta Shabda. Tavatu. Generally with verbs ending with dhatus with these pratyayas, Shatra Sati Saptami is seen. And this saptami is given by a sutra. Yasya cha bhavena bhava lakshanam. Yasya cha bhavena bhava lakshanam. Tasya cha bhavena bhavalakshanam is the sutra. So yasya bhavena, bhavena means kriyaya. Bhavena means kriyaya. By whose action? Yasya bhavena bhavalakshanam. Bhavalakshanam means kriyantaram lakshyate. Yasya kriyaya kriyantaram lakshyate. By whose action another action is defined, tataha saptami syat, tataha lakshyate, tataha saptami syat. Yasya bhavena, by whose action, bhavaha means another action, lakshyate is defined, tataha saptami syat, after that means after that, after whose action, the action is, yasya bhavena. Yasya refers to X. The action of X defines another action. Then tataha means after the X, saptami should be used. Saptami is added, is used. After used after the one whose action defines another action, defines or qualifies another action. Just the sutra, but we have to understand the practical usage of sati saptami. See, suryaha udeti, suryaha udeti. Udeti is what? Nat prathama purusha ekavachanam. This is one sentence. Suryaha udeti. No. Kamalam vikasati. lotus blossoms. This is another sentence. In Suryaha Udeti, what is the bhava? Kriya Udeti. Rising of sun is one action. Kamalam Vikasati, blooming of lotus. Blooming is another action. So this is one bhava, this is another bhava. I want to qualify or define Vikasati with Udeti. How? When sun has risen, when sun is rising, or when sun has risen, lotus blooms. If I make this statement, then I am defining Vikasati with Udeti. I am explaining Vikasati with the help of Udeti. I am qualifying Vikasati with Udeti. So when sun has risen, lotus blossoms. So when lotus blossoms, I am explaining. So when lotus blossoms, so see, when does lotus bloom? You can say in the morning. That is one answer. But I am not answering the question when with a time particular, with any noun. Instead of saying a noun, I am using another verb, another action. I am answering the question when with another verb. Then the other verb is defining this verb, this action. Other verb, Udeti, is defining this. In the sense, this verb is, this action is giving the time of this action. You understand?
Yeah.
So, I can say this. Yada Suryaha Uditaha. Suryaha Uditaha. Uditaha means Ud plus Ta. Ud plus In. In plus Ta. E is the dhatu. Ud is upasarga. In dhatu. And Ta pratyaya. Uditaha has risen. Tada Kamalam Vikasati. I can say this with yada tada. Yada suryaha uditaha tada kamalam vikasati. This is one way of saying. Or yeah. But I don't want to use yada tada. I want to put it in a different way. Then what will I do? This one, Udeti, I will make it into Tanta, Udita. Surya, Suryaha, Uditaha. And then, I am not writing Surya, just Surya and Udita will be right. Kamalam Vikasati. Surya Udita Kamalam Vikasati. Now, Udita is a Kriya which is defining Vikasati. This serves as a Lakshanam of Vikasati. It acts as a definition or a qualification of Vikasati. Because when this action happens, Vikasati action happens, a Therefore, this serves as a lakshana of this action. Now, this action belongs to Surya. So, this is the bhava, a kriya of Surya. So, therefore, I can say, Suryasya bhavena, Suryasya kriyaya, kriyantaram. Kriyantaram means vikasati kriya, vikasana kriya, lakshyate. In this sentence, Suryasya kriyaya, Suryasya udaya kriyaya, kriyantaram, nama vikasana kriya, lakshyate. Therefore, Surya will take Saptami. Surya will take Saptami. Because Surya is the one whose action is defining another action. Therefore, it should be Surya Saptami. Udite. See, when Surya takes Saptami, even Udita will take Saptami. Surya Udite. Because Udite is a verb which is in Samanadhikarana with Surya. Udite qualifies Surya. Therefore, Udite also will take Saptami. And for our convenience, we can add a Sati here. Sati. Surya Udite Sati. Even without Sati, it is complete. But you can add a Sati. Udite Sati. Surya Udite Sati. Kamadam Vikasati. So, you know, this is called Sati Saptami. This Saptami. Surya. It is called Sati Saptami. Surya Udite Sati. Kamadam Vikasati. When the sun has risen, lotus blooms. Udite is not lat. See, lat is a tinanta. This is a kridanta. See, tinanta cannot have saptami, prathama and all. Okay. It is a kridanta. See, there is a ta pratyaya. Ta pratyaya is generally used in the sense of karmani. But sometimes in an akarmaka dhatu, ta can be used in the sense of kartani. Kartani. Karmani or bhave. But after a ta pratyaya, it can be used in the sense of kartani. For example, suryaha uditaha. Ta is used in the sense of kartani. Like, see. Rama. See, so there are certain krit pratyayas. For example, ta and tavatu. See, tavatu. How tavatu will be? Rama. Gatavat, it becomes Gatavan in Prathama Ekavachanam. See, Gatavat is the Pratipadika. Gam plus Tavatu. becomes a gatavat. Gatavat. This is pratipadika. In pullinga, prathama eka vachanam, it becomes gatavan. Gatavan. You can see how it is derived. We have done it in halanta pullinga prakaram. See, Ramaha gatavan. Ramaha gatavan. Rama went. Gatavan means went. Then when Rama has gone, Dasharathaha roditi, roditi, cries. So I am qualifying this roditi with the gatava. How? Yasya cha bhavena bhava lakshmanam rame. This will become rame. Gatavati sati dasharathaha roditi. This is sati saptami. To understand sati saptami properly, you should understand the usage of these pratyaya, these pradantas. Ta pratyaya, tavatu, shatrashanach. We need another session for that only. Shatrashanach and ta tavatu. You have to understand the usage of these pratyayas, how they are used. If that is understood, then sati saptami is easy to understand. See, shatra shanach. Shatra and shanach are two pratyayas. They are krat pratyayas. They are given in kridanta prakaran. Latash shatrashana chau aprathama samanadhikarane. That is one sutra for shatrashana pratyaya. Another is lakshana hetoha kriyaya. It is another sutra for shatrashana pratyaya. Let us see Shatrashanach. It is better to give some explanation on Shatrashanach. See, any verb, any dhatu can take Shatra or Shanach. Shatra and Shanach are used in present tense. First thing is present tense. They are used in present tense. Then Shatru is Parasmai Padam. Shatra is Parasmai Padam. Shanach is Atmane Padam. Shanach is Atmane Padam. Shatra is Parasmai Padam. Shanach is सात्मनि एंड बोथ आर कर्तर सॉरी कर्तरी कर्मणि और भाव कर्तरी कर्मणि भाव इन ऑल दीज थ्री सेंसेस दे कैन बी यूज्ड नो सी गम प्लस शत्रु इट विल बिकम गच्छत गच्छत तकाराम then let us take the verb as as means to sit shana it will become asina 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 is a shanach pratyayanta in other languages also we use asina ಆಸೀನರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ವೇದಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಆಸೀನರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ದೇಶ ಆಸೀನ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಉಪವಿಷ್ಟ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಶತ್ರುಶಾನಚ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ रामः वनं गच्छति दशरथः रामं पश्यति दशरथः रामं पश्यति रामा इस गोइंग टू फॉरेस्ट एंड दशरथ सीज राम आई वांट टू कंबाइन दीज टू सेंटेंसेस हाउ I want to bring this vanam gacchati here. How? See, in a sentence, in a single sentence, there can be only one main word. Only one main verb is possible. And the main verb will be a tinganta. The main verb will be tinganta. Then there can be a subordinate verb. The subordinate verb cannot be a tinganta. It has to be a kriganta. Main verb is always tinganta, generally tinganta. A subordinate verb will always be a kridanta. This is a general rule. So now, the दशरथः रामं पश्यति कैन ही ब्रिंग वनं गच्छति जस्ट लाइक दैट एंड फिट हियर दशरथः वनं गच्छति रामं पश्यति आई कैन नॉट फिट जस्ट लाइक दैट बिकॉज़ दिस इज गच्छति इज आल्सो ए तिङन्त जस्ट लाइक पश्यति सो If I bring Gacchati here, then I am making this Tinanta a subordinate to this Pashyati, another Tinanta. Then they will have ego clash. Two Tinanta, among two Tinanta, one cannot become subordinate to another. So, I have to cut this thing here. I have to cut the thing. Instead of thing, I have to add a krit pratyaya. And the krit pratyaya which is suitable here would be what? Shatru pratyaya. Because this is present tense. This is present tense. So, gam plus shatru becomes gachat. Gacchat. In the same sense as this ti, I have added shat. And this gacchat, see this is in samana adhikarana with the Rama. Ramaha vanam gacchati. Gacchati is kartari. That means it is in samana adhikarana with the Rama. What is samana adhikarana? Both are referring to same. Gacchati and Rama, both are referring to same. So, Gacchati is in Samanadhikarana with Rama. So, therefore, Gacchat also is in Samanadhikarana with Rama. So, Gacchat is also is in Samanadhikarana with Rama. Now, when it fits into this sentence, when, see here Gacchati, Ramaha Gacchati, when it comes to this sentence, here Ramaha is in Dvitiya Vibhakti. Why Ramaha is Dvitiya Vibhakti? Why Ramaha is Dvitiya Vibhakti here in the second sentence? Karma. Karmani Dvitiya. Anabhihite Karmani Dvitiya. So, since Rama is Dvitiya Vibhakti, Gacchat, which is qualifying Rama, also should be in Dvitiya Vibhakti. Therefore, how I should write? Dasharathaha vanam gacchantam. Gacchantam is Dvitiya Vibhakti of Gacchat. Ramam pashyati. Dasharathaha vanam gacchantam ramam pashyati. That is how Shatra Pratyaya is used. Dasharathaha vanam gacchantam ramam pashyati. पिबति बालकः फलं खादति बालकः क्षीरं पिबति Here both the actions are done by the same person. See, in the previous example, two actions were done by two different people. Now, same, both actions are done by Balakaha only. Now, I want to combine these two sentences. Balakaha phalam khadati, Balakaha kshiram pibati. Here, I want to combine these two sentences. Where I want to make khadati subordinate to pibati. And both are present tense only. Both are present tense. And I want to make one subordinate to another. For that, I can make khadati into kshatramda. How? Balakaha khalam खादन क्षीरं पिबति बालकः फलं खादन सी हियर इट इज 1-1 बिकॉज़ बालकः इज 1-1 बालकः फलं खादन क्षीरं पिबति So this is another way of using Kshatra Pratyaya.
So in the previous sentence also we can say Gacchan.
Previous sentence you because cannot say Gacchan because Rama is Ditya Vibhakti. Gacchantam. So when the Karta is in Ditya Vibhakti, even this should be in Ditya Vibhakti. शिशुः शेते शेते मीन्स स्लीप्स शेते इज लट् लकार इट इज आत्मनेपदम् लट् लकार प्रथम पुरुष एकवचन शिशुः शेते माता शिशुं प्रबोधयति माता शिशुं प्रबोधयति शिशु इज स्लीपिंग माता इज वेकिंग अप द शिशु नाउ आई वांट टू से इन वन सेंटेंस मदर इज वेकिंग अप द शिशु हु इज स्लीपिंग शानच सिंस इट इज आत्मनेपदि शीन धातु इज आत्मनेपदि आई कैन नॉट यूज अ शत्र आई हैव टू यूज शानच सो शेते विल बिकम शयान शिशु सॉरी माता माता शयानम शयानम शिशुम प्रबोधयति माता शयानम शिशुम प्रबोधयति शिशु इज द्वितीय बिकॉज इट इज ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ प्रबोधयति एंड शयानम इज इन समानाधिकरण विद शिशु Therefore, even Shayanam will be in Vritya Vibhakti. Shayanam or Asinam. Mata Asinam Putram Uttapayati. Uttapayati. उत्थापयति मीन्स मेक्स हिम गेट अप माता शयानम माता आसीनम पुत्रम उत्थापयति दीस आर यूसेजेस ऑफ शत्र प्रत्यय देवदत्तः हसन भाषते देवदत्त हसन लाफिंग भाषते स्पीक्स ही स्पीक्स वाइल लाफिंग हसन भाषते ऑल दीस आर द यूसेजेस ऑफ शत्र प्रत्यय सो शत्रुशानच सिमिलरली तव तवत are also used. Ta and tavatu are past tense. But the difference between shatrashanach and ta tavatu is ta tavatu can be used independently without a tinanta. Whereas shatrashanach cannot be used in a sentence without a tinanta. They have to be used only as subordinate to etinanta. When shatra or shanach are used, they are always used as subordinate to etinanta.
सूत्र जाल